Diabetes is the leading cause of blindness in Africa, yet by and large preventable or at least treatable. To discuss about that, I then visited the eye specialist, the ophthalmologist, Dr. Solomon Guramatunhu.
I think the first thing to make this very clear is for people to understand that diabetes is a disease of blood vessels. Two things happen to the blood vessels. Number one, the blood vessels leak. So they are leaking blood, they are leaking water, they are also leaking foodstuffs, the food that we eat. The second thing is that the walls of the blood vessels become very thick to the extent that they actually close. So there's no movement of blood at all. So if we imagine blood vessels which are supplying the foot, by the time they get to the foot, most of the blood is leaked already. Some of the vessels have closed already. So there's very little blood that gets to the foot. So as a result, patients then feel numbness and they'll say, "You know, I don't feel a bit numb." That's because they're not getting enough blood supply. If this gets worse, then you find even if they put their foot into fire, they can't feel it because they've lost all sensation. That gets worse, then you get gangrene. In other words, the toes and the feet are getting rotten. They slow in the human body. Then doctors have to amputate the legs. That's why it happens in diabetes. But this happens all over the body. So the kidneys, for instance, if there's not enough blood coming to the kidneys, then you have kidney failure. That is why people with diabetes end up having dialysis to try and help the kidneys because they're not working very well. Same thing with the heart. The heart muscle is pumping. But if the heart muscle does not get enough blood supply, then you have heart attack, and that happens in diabetes. The brain, if not enough blood supply gets to the brain, then you have stroke in diabetes. Now, the eye is part of the brain, and at the back of the eye is the retina, which is like the photographic film of the eye. You remember those old cameras that had the film? So that's the film of the eye. What happens is the retina is not getting enough blood supply. First of all, the things that I mentioned, the leakage of the hemorrhages, blood, and the deposits of the foods we eat. When we look at a patient, we look at the back and we take pictures and we can see these things happening. So we know, oh yes, they have diabetes, now they have diabetic eye disease. So if the retina does not get enough blood supply, it tries to fight. And by doing that, it produces new blood vessels. But these don't grow on the wall, but they grow inside. They just jut into the eye. They are abnormal. So they easily break open. So the patient will say, "Doctor, yesterday my vision was good. I woke up this morning, I can't see," because now the eye is full of blood. Now that blood, if normally they have frequent bleeds, eventually it pulls, it fibrosis and pulls the retina. That's how patients go blind with diabetes.
But how much does diabetes contribute to eye problems in Africa?
Diabetes is the number one cause of blindness all over the world, and that includes us in Africa. And for us, it's quite bad because a lot of patients go for a long time, either they don't even know that they're diabetic, or the diabetes is poorly managed. So this is a big, big problem. And I would say to anyone who's listening, if you are diabetic, members of your family are diabetic, or your friends are diabetic, please, they must have their eyes checked immediately, and certainly on a regular basis, at least once a year. That's very, very important, because the blindness can be prevented if the disease is picked up early. So it's very important, number one, for the sugar levels to be normal. They should always be maintained normal. If the sugar sometimes is very high, sometimes too low, it causes problems. Eventually you have complications that we're talking about. Secondly, blood pressure must be well under control. The cholesterol must also be checked under control. And the weight, the patients must reduce weight. Now, if those things are under control, then we come to the eyes. If someone is diagnosed to have diabetes, immediately, whether by the physician, or the general practitioner, or the optician, they must be referred to the eye specialist immediately, so that we ascertain the state of diabetes in the eye. Because sometimes they've had diabetes for a long time, they didn't know. But when the diagnosis is made, 6 months later, a year later, they probably already have eye complications, diabetic eye complications. So we assist these patients. If there is no diabetes in the eye, then we can say, okay, we'll see them after a year, provided they're carrying on those four things that we mentioned. If there is diabetes already in the eye, then we determine whether it's just background, where you just have these hemorrhages and these deposits and so on, and we can see them later, maybe 6 months or so. But if there is bleeding already, then there's immediate treatment. And the mainstay of treatment for diabetes is laser treatment. If there is lots of blood, the eye is full of blood, and the blood is not clearing, because sometimes it does clear on its own, it's not clearing, then they need the vitreoretinal surgery, which is very advanced surgery with very expensive equipment.
And if you want to get your eyes checked, where exactly can you go?
Any eye specialist, and as you know, we train eye specialists here in Zimbabwe, would have been trained how to examine a diabetic patient for diabetic eye complications. So any ophthalmologist anywhere, whether it's in a central hospital, a provincial hospital, as long as we have somebody who's been trained to look at eyes, they should be able to diagnose and say, yes, we have a problem or we don't have a problem.
What if I'm diabetic and I can see clearly without any problem?
That doesn't matter. Because what happens initially, they may have very good vision, whereas already they have diabetic eye disease. So if they are lucky that way, it means we need to maintain that vision by giving them laser treatment or whatever treatment they need. If they have good vision and there's no diabetic eye disease, that's fine. But a lot of patients will actually be seeing well with central vision, but already they have complications. So they need to be seen. So everybody with diabetes must be seen immediately. And then thereafter, the doctor can determine how often they see them.